In Don't Hate the Playa News.
Chinese
don't
people
hate the playa
are the best, and so are Armenians.
I don't want
to
be
fucking time these videos now. I ain't a playa, I just crush a lot.
Oh shit.
Submitted by Long Hair Don't Occur.
Long Hair Don't Occur!
My hair is longer than yours, fool.
The two girls with the shortest hair did it.
What happened to your hair, though? Can I? I mean, I know we're not close, but
he got in a fight with a fucking weed
whacker.
Have
you heard of Picasso?
Did you go into the barber and say fuck?
He's held
have you heard of Picasso?
In a ponytail.
Picasso or
your dog cut your hair.
Do you have a Valentine this year?
This, no,
right?
I don't.
Oh, I mean, I think I know why. Hair. I think it's the hair.
I bet you he'll be my Valentine. I bet you he gets all the ladies in Missouri.
The eyes in the cartoon and then gets out.
That's good acting. That's A1 acting,
like,
huh?
Water that's forming.
I am
it
crying.
It turned into this shape.
Honestly, though, it takes big balls to have a fucked up haircut like that, so good for you.
My literal balls are quite small, but my hypothetical balls are large.
You got big ball energy.
You see, she doesn't even know you.
And she knows I got big dick energy, Gio.
No,
small cock, big energy.
She was just trying not to be such an asshole, but she's speaking the truth.
Those were loud claps.
Yeah, what are you doing?
I'm passionate.
Those were good claps.
I'm passionate.
Oh, you want to clap off?
Oh, no.
Shit.
I'll clap too, motherfucker. I'll clap. Oh, let's go.
Okay.
I'll fucking clap that ass.
He threw it back.
You
make
win.
Make that ass clap.
All right, you win.
All right, Gio. An airline is suing a customer who skipped a leg of his flight to save money. I don't get it.
What?
This is real.
The airline is suing a customer?
Skip the leg of his
flight. Yeah, so, sorry. I'm trying to fix it.
So it's just the empty seat.
No. A leg of flight meaning like a
connecting flight, right?
Yeah.
That's what we did.
I know, but you just said something about an empty seat.
So I think for us, it was, what do we do? So when we sponsored this one powerlifting event in Texas, and they lost our luggage. I forgot what the order of events was, but the flight itself was gonna take like 3 or 4 hours just because of layover or whatever. And we're like, fuck it, let's just rent a car. So we'll rent the car, but we'll get back on the airplane once we're there.
Yeah.
And that was cool with the airline.
What airline?
Now, how do they sue you
which
for
airline?
American?
American? Because United probably most likely would have canceled the rest of your.
Wait, what?
Just because you skipped that one
spot. Wait. Say I'm going. Hey! Yeah, I'm going to New York. All right? And I got to go from here to Dallas to Philly to New York.
Okay.
And I'm making my way to Dallas.
Cheap ass? Why don't you get a direct flight?
I'm cheap.
Sometimes those are long.
I fly into Dallas, and I say, wow, you know, I've never driven to Philly. Let's take a little road tripper. And so I quickly rent a car, and I get there. And then I hop on my next fucking flight to New York. And you're going to sue me.
If it's United.
I'm a goddamn American. I can do whatever I want.
This is how it works. A lot of people, are hacking.
It's called hidden cities.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, well, then I definitely want to do this.
So sometimes it's cheaper to get a connector flight than a direct flight.
Oh, from a different company.
So, like, imagine if you want to go to Philly. Imagine if you want to go to Philly, right? Yeah. Instead of going directly to New York, you find that there's a one-stop ticket going to New York that's cheaper. So some people just go straight to Philly and don't go on the connecting flight to New York.
Yeah, but so that should be legal too, right?
Let me tell you guys the way this customer did.
Yeah.
So he was flying Lufthansa.
Lufthansa.
First mistake.
Yeah, so it's a German airline.
Really?
German airline.
Oh, Germans are cool.
It's the national airline of Germany.
I'm not very cultured, you know? Can you not point that out? The screens are on.
I'm trying to teach you.
All right. Yeah, dude, I love that. I love the national. Let's go Germans.
Okay, so this passenger booked a flight from Seattle to Oslo, Norway, with a layover in Frankfurt, Germany, and then he intentionally missed the connecting flight, and he boarded a different Lufthansa flight.
Oh, to somewhere else.
He was headed to Berlin because that was his intended destination, Berlin. But Germany was the hidden city, so that was it's cheaper to book to get to Germany rather than.
But not actually go, just take a left turn on a different flight.
Yeah, so he didn't actually go to Norway, which was like that, you know, Seattle on the way to Norway, right? He stopped in Germany because he wanted to get to Berlin.
I think I get it.
That was cheaper than a direct flight to Berlin.
He just skipped the latter part of it and he jumped on another plane.
Yep. Because going direct.
Same example I gave you. Instead of going straight to Philly,
you want to go to Philly.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
So instead of flying that direct to Philly flight, you get the connector flight and it's cheaper.
But that shouldn't be illegal.
Yeah, what's
but it is.
Well,
not illegal, but
not against
illegal.
Their policy.
Yeah.
Fuck your policy.
And so this dude could have gotten away with it if he didn't book the same Lufthansa flight for the second part, because then that's how they were able to figure it out. Like, oh, he cheated the system. And so
they're smart. Why would they do
that? They're so petty that they're suing him for about $2,300 in damages.
What damage? They had an empty seat.
You know what's crazy? They just did this news report article or whatever on how air flights, you're not covered for shit. Like, they don't have to be on time. They don't have to even fly out. Like, that's the risk you take with all the
they don't even have to give you your seat.
They don't even have to give you your seat.
Wow.
Yeah, like, if you really read the fine print, they protect themselves 100% and you, like, zero.
That's why they overbook flights.
Yep, they overbook.
And then you could be there and then they're like, oh, it's overbooked. Even though you bought it and you have your seat and all that shit.
Yeah.
That's what happened to Dr. Dow.
Oh, right.
Just kill me. Well, so, I mean, they overbooked the flight.
Oh,
it was their fault.
True.
Or like that family that had to sit on the floor.
They can kick you out. They can do all kinds of shit.
Yeah, and you're not protected at all.
Well, I don't get the policy, though. I get the unprotection, and I kind of But, like, you're getting my money. You got my money.
Twice. But that's not the point. So they're saying here...
What's the point, though?
So they're saying that by using this hidden city loophole, it has a cascading effect. So if gate agents, like, for example, gate agents could hold the flight for that passenger who has no intentions of showing up, which then will delay flight.
Fuck you.
Which is bullshit because they've never held a flight for me.
They have never.
United, I got in a huge argument with United one time over like a bunch of these little things that
United
they don't cover
sucks
you.
Sucks ass.
Yeah, a bunch of things. But they say they will only hold a flight if there's like 15 people missing.
Yep. Damn.
Yeah, they're going to take off.
So then they could have just changed that other policy.
They're for sure. They just want to be petty.
They're also saying though that when a customer purchase a flight that they have no intention on taking, it could drive up the prices for other customers.
Like, you give a fuck, you get more money,
yeah.
I'm so rich.
Yep, and so they're saying that, have you guys ever heard of this website called Skiplacked?
No.
So this website specializes in finding these hidden cities for you.
I need that.
So they tell you, like,
what's it called?
Skiplacked, okay.
Do they find hidden cities with first class tickets?
Dude, there's hella travel hacks these days.
United Airlines and Orbitz filed a joint suit against the 22-year-old coder behind Skiplacked back in 2014. But then they were actually claiming $75,000 in damages because United was arguing that it was unfairly competing with other booking sites and promoting strictly prohibited travel, and then Orbitz joined that suit because Skiplacked would redirect the passengers through Orbitz, which then it would be forcing the site to violate its own contract with United.
That's fucking dope.
Yeah, so a judge ended up throwing out the case.
That's dope.
It was filed in Chicago, and the 22-year-old coder, he doesn't either live there or work there in that jurisdiction, so then that was thrown out.
And he said, fuck it, I'm gonna keep going.
Yeah, he's been going. Like,
the website's still up?
Yeah, you can still go to Skiplacked. Not sponsored, but hey, if you want to.
I mean, the airline industry is so fucked now, too, because remember when we were little, we didn't have... of course, we didn't have to pay, but no one paid for
food, drinks,
extra shit.
I got McDonald's on flights as a kid.
But then
we flew to Cleveland all the time to visit my dad.
You never had to pay for carry on.
It wasn't extra.
Or extra luggage. Or
to pick your damn seat.
Pick your seat. Nah, none of that stuff. All of that shit was just included. And one of the reasons why is the airline industry was actually regulated.
Yeah.
So there was more competition, and then they deregulated it thinking that there would be more competition, right? And so what ended up happening was there were like, I don't know, like 20 major airlines, and there were so many more airlines competing against for customers and all that. And they had to have direct flights to major cities from smaller cities. Like, I don't know, like, I think Oklahoma City or whatever. There's like smaller cities in the Midwest that they had to connect with. But now we only have, it's like an oligopoly now. There's only four left: Southwest, Delta, United, and American Airlines. Sure, you have Alaska, JetBlue, all them, but they're not, they only have like 10% market share. They don't have, the majority of it are these big airlines. And for them to save money, they cut all of the access to smaller cities and destroyed their economy.
Damn.
Yeah. And now, because they all in cahoots with each other, they all call each other up behind the scenes and they go, all right, guys, let's start charging for these extra things. Since there's no competition, they can charge for all that extra shit.
Because flights are still just expensive or more expensive than ever, even though you think the price will go down over time slightly.
Yeah. Like, I don't see what's wrong with this.
I don't either. I still don't get it.
I'm trying to think of, like, in the worst case scenario, if everyone starts doing this, then they have pilots, the plane gassed up, everything ready, and then there's two people that are actually going to take the second leg to Germany when everyone else wants to go.
Yeah,
but
it's...
But they also overbook. Too.
Yeah.
How many people are on the standby and how many times do they have to pay
out? So they're doing it on their end. They're like gaming their system on their own end if they overbook.
Yeah, we can't do that in return.
Or just make more direct flights at a whatever cost or more places where I want to go at a better cost.
Well, they're also struggling too because the only airlines that are making actual substantial money is discount airlines in Europe. All the domestic airlines, all of them, like, they're not making enough. So that's kind of weird too, because there's less competition. So I don't know how the economics works, but I watched a whole part on it, a documentary on it, and they're saying like a lot of these major airlines with massive jets and stuff like that, they're not making that much because if they take a huge risk on and plus the air fuel, like it's super expensive, right? So if they don't fill up that flight, then they lose money, a fuck ton of money. Yeah. So, I don't know.
But yeah, I don't know. Lufthansa's being fucking petty.
Yeah, to sue one person, yep. When I'm sure tons of people do that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.